Hello students, welcome in the math class. As we have already discussed the first four objectives of AP, that is to find the particular term when nth term is given, second to find an AP when nth term is given, third to find particular term using general term formula, fourth to find the number of terms using general term formula. Today we are going to start with very important questions based on these types. First of all, when three terms of AP are given and we have to find the value of the variable, for example, if x plus 1, 3x and 4x plus 2 are consecutive terms of AP, find the value of x. As x plus 1, 3x and 4x plus 2 are in AP, so these must be the consecutive first three terms of AP. Now, as they are in AP, their common difference should be same. That is, second term minus first term must be equal to third term minus second term. Now, put their values. We get 3x minus x plus 1 equal to 4x plus 2 minus 3x. Now, when you open the bracket, sign will change. We get 3x minus x minus 1 equal to 4x plus 2 minus 3x. Now 3x minus x is 2x minus 1 as it is equal to 4x minus 3x is x plus 2 as it is. Now click like terms, we get 2x minus x is equal to 2 plus 1. Therefore finally we get x is equal to 3. Therefore value of x is 3. Next important type of question is of type 4. Is minus 13 a term of sequence 13, 8, 3 and so on? Here series is given and we have to check for minus 13. Given first term A is equal to 13, D we can find by subtracting the terms 8 minus 13 or 3 minus 8. So we get D is equal to minus 5. Now for minus 13 is a term, suppose it is a nth term. Therefore Tn is equal to minus 13. Apply the general term formula, that is A plus n minus 1d is equal to minus 13. Now put the value of A and D. We get 13 plus n minus 1 multiply minus 5 is equal to minus 13. Here apply the arrow method. We get 13 minus 5n plus 5 is equal to minus 13. Now 13 plus 5, 18 minus 5n is equal to minus 13. Shift 18 to other side. Minus 5n is equal to minus 13 minus 18. Minus 5n is equal to minus 31. Minus minus cancel. So we get n is equal to 31 upon 5. As we know, for number of terms, n can't be fractional, n can't be negative, n can't be 0. It must be a natural number. But here 31 upon 5 is not a natural number. Therefore minus 13 is not a term of the given sequence. Next important question is there to find the first negative term of an AP. For example, which term is the first negative term of AP 21, 18, 15 and so on. Here, as the terms of this AP are decreasing, so there must be a negative term. We have to find that negative term. Here, A is first term, that is 21. D we can find by subtracting the terms, that is 18 minus 21 or 15 minus 18. We get D is equal to minus 3. Now suppose that nth term of this series is a first negative term. Tn is less than 0. Apply the formula. We get A plus n minus 1d is less than 0. Put the value of A and D. 21 plus n minus 1 into minus 3 is less than 0. Here again apply the arrow method. We get 21 minus 3n plus 3 is less than 0. 21 plus 3 is 24 minus 3n less than 0. Shift 3n to the other side, we get 24 is less than 3n. From here Shifting 3, we get n is greater than 8. Now, n must be greater than 8, so value of n can be taken as 9. Therefore, first negative term will be the 9th term of this sequence. Now, students, you are able to solve these type of important questions. Before starting the worksheet given in SNAP homework, please go through the links as guided in the SNAP homework. Rest, we will continue in the next session. Thank you.